All right, it's time for business now on France 24. Kate Moody is in the studio.
Hi, James.
And we're looking at the GAFA tax that's been dubbed.
Yeah.
And so it's a new measure in France to tax digital giants. Will it be effective? Is it going to work?
Well, it's the question that a lot of people are certainly asking as the administration pushes ahead with this. It has really been a key issue for President Macron. He tried and failed to get approval on an EU-wide level. Now the government is pushing ahead on its own. The tax will apply to internet and technology companies like Google, Apple and Facebook, which have global turnover of more than 750 euros or French revenue of 25 million. They'll see a 3% tax on digital revenues, which include platforms that sell products from third parties, as well as earnings from digital advertising and selling personal data. Luke Trego's been taking a closer look.
500 million euros. That's how much the French taxman thinks the government could initially gain from a 3% levy on digital sales, in a move to bring internet giants like Google, Amazon, Facebook and Apple to heel.
International cooperation is required, is really trying to fix the international tax system for taxing profits. It's far too easy for companies to shift their profits around between countries and make those profits appear in low tax jurisdictions. It's actually moving the place of taxation, where we're going to tax Google's profits, to the place where they make their sales.
That, however, is precisely where previous efforts have fallen down. France has already failed to gain traction at the EU level after low tax jurisdictions like Ireland, concerned over a loss of investment, blocked action. Even Germany was tepid on the idea, fearing US retaliation against its car industry. And critics have said it doesn't go far enough to address the issue on a wider scale.
The measure is more symbolic and comes from a need to answer the yellow vest protesters who want more than anything else a fairer tax system. Remember that digital giants are experts when it comes to tax optimization. Whatever they do, whatever we think, it might look immoral, but it's not illegal.
France may have been leading the charge in Europe, though the UK, Spain and Italy are all working on their own versions of a digital tax, and Japan, Singapore and India are looking into the idea too. That leaves the pressure on at OECD negotiations in Paris to tie disparate national efforts into a global agreement, something France hopes could be the case by next year.
The OECD has slashed its growth forecast for major European economies. In its latest forecast, the Economic Policy Organization predicted significantly lower growth for the Eurozone as a whole, as well as France, Germany, and the UK next year. It blames policy uncertainty over issues like Brexit and trade for that gloomier outlook. Now, we've been speaking to the OECD's chief economist, Laurence Boone, about what that means for the UK in particular. Take a listen.
We've revised down our projection for the UK, which is now supposed to grow at a little bit less than 1%. And it's due to some extent to the Brexit and the impact it has on investment, as we were mentioning. But obviously, the UK is an open economy, and it's also being dragged down by the uncertainty created by the trade tensions around the world, and to some extent, the slowdown in China, which is another one of our concerns.
Let's check in on the day's trading action now. A mixed close for the major European indices after that rather gloomy forecast. The DAX down nearly a third of one percentage point in Frankfurt. The CAC 40 slightly less here in Paris. Burberry shares fell 4%. Wall Street's trading in the red. The Dow Jones shedding 150 points. Amazon shares have fallen about 1%. CNBC is reporting that Donald Trump has been urging U.S. trade negotiators to quickly reach a deal with China in order to boost stock prices. America's trade deficit has hit a 10-year high. That means the U.S. economy exported far less than it imported. The figures for December had been delayed because of the government shutdown. They show a 19% jump in the last month of the year, bringing the total gap for 2018 to $621 billion. The lion's share comes from China, which sold $419 billion worth more than it bought, despite the country's tit-for-tat tariffs. The gap with the EU and Mexico also increased. President Donald Trump has been fixated on reducing the U.S. trade deficit, citing it as one of the reasons for imposing trade tariffs on China as well as America's traditional allies. Administration officials have suggested that those policies will bear fruit down the road, but perhaps not immediately. Italy is reportedly preparing to become the first G7 nation to join China's Belt and Road Initiative. That's according to the Financial Times, which says Rome will make the formal endorsement when Xi Jinping visits at the end of the month. Launched in 2013 as a 21st century Silk Road, the development strategy aims to build infrastructure in more than 80 mostly developing countries. Both Washington and Brussels have expressed skepticism about the project, which they say favors Chinese companies, advances Beijing's strategic power, and can trap at-risk economies in higher debt. Iran is making progress in its preparations for a special payments vehicle to bypass U.S. sanctions. France, Germany, and the U.K. have taken steps to open the trade channel on their end. The idea is to facilitate non-dollar trading between European economies and Tehran so that users won't risk violating American sanctions, which were put in place after Donald Trump withdrew Washington from the international nuclear deal. During discussions on that agreement in Vienna, Iran's representative said the payment system could be operational by the end of the month.
We hope that in the coming weeks, Instex would become operational. It starts from humanitarian in order to set the patterns for doing business with Iran. And once the patterns are set, then other kind of goods, including sanctioned goods and oil, of course, would be added to this mechanism.
All right, Kate, that's all the business for now. You'll be back in 1 hour's time.
Absolutely.